fellas, so excuse me, I decided to procrastinate a little bit more, and I wanted to put some basis into Kuat, and I thought it would be a good time to make a video to how to do some coding for that. Now I'm only going to put two bases in, just to show you the process, and then I'll gradually finish that as the week progresses. Excuse me for the coughing, I'm still sick and actually getting worse, so I apologize if that gets kind of annoying. So anyways, the way that you put bases into a system is not actually too bad, but it's a little bit of a process to do all the file work. So you first start off actually making things bases. So what I'm going to do is make two bases right now. I'm going to make a base for the Kuat planet, and as well as the Kuat drive yards. So, I'm going to start here. So, all these modular components don't really matter so much in the docking. Docking has to do with, you have to make an object dockable, and the way that you do that, and I'll just show you very, very briefly, is through the actual model itself. So, if you go to any of the ships, or actual ships, or the models for the modular components, you'll see that there's some interesting hard-pointing things. And I'll just go to that right now. So, for example, the ISD, to make that dockable, you have to have these things called, firstly you have to have a HP dock mount, and that's typically where the endpoint will be. So I put that as close to the model as possible. In this case, it's right there. It's very, very close to the model if I scroll out. And then what really matters actually is the orientation. Now this is how the actual ship will come out, and you have to make a trail of it. So that's the dock mount, and that makes it dockable. And now this is the path it follows. So then you have a dock point A, and I usually put that right on top of the dock mount A. See how that won't change right over here? The positioning or the orientation. And then you have the dock point A1, and that's the game knows to follow that out at a certain speed, and I think that is actually a constant. And then you have A2, which is a little bit further out. Now I usually put them at increments of approximately 100, so dock point A is 100, or maybe 50 in this case, I think, and dock point A1 is 150. Then dock point A2 is 200, and they're all following the same direction. And this will actually make the ship go down from the model itself. And then you have to have a docking camera, which it will actually follow it by itself. All you have to do is have it in the correct orientation. So kind of just to show you guys again, so you get it. So I'll do the MC-80 here. Okay, so that's the ship there. And if you look, there's a dock mount A, and that's where it starts. Pull out there, so it's right there. And then you have dock point A, which is in the same spot. And then you have dock mount A1, which is a little bit further out. And I think I put it about 100 from that. Yeah, so I put this one. In this case, it was 100. And it's a set limit. So the further you put further away you put the docking points, the faster the ship will move. And it's important that you have the orientation the same for all of them, or the ship will be caught in a dock sequence, or the undocking sequence in this case. So that's a very quick down and dirty method of making things dockable. It's really, really easy. All you have to do is make sure you have these points, which is easy to put in and easy to remember, because all you need to do is put, so for example, I want to put a new docking point here, new, and you make sure it's a fixed type. In this case, you have to make sure it's always in route or it won't work. And then you have all these set points here. So the first thing you want to put is a dock mount A, and if you wanted something to else be docked there at a different docking point, you put a dock mount B. And then you have to make a dock point A, which is and then you just use incremental numbers. So, for example, you use numbering screen scheme. So, as you see here, you have dock mount A, and you have dock point, sorry, dock mount A, and then you have a dock point A, and you have a dock point A01, and a dock point A02, and that's generally all you need to make things dockable. So, anyways, now that you guys figure that out, or I explain that to you, getting back to what I'm doing here. So in this case, I want to make this quad drive yards dockable, and just always, as I say, I always use my old materials reference, and I'll go back to my course count here. Let's go open. There we go. Alright. So, scroll on this one. And pop this one out. Okay. So looking at them side by side, what I need to add, I'll add ID info later. That's why, I don't know if you watched me evaluate a system, it came out as KDY. You have to have, for whatever reason, an IDS info, and that will keep it quite drive yards. And I can do that later, it's no biggie deal. So I have the positioning right, and I have the rotation right, and I have the archetype, and I have the loadout. Now, what I'll do here is I'll make this dockable by putting it as a base. So let's put that in there, and then I'll call this quad drive yards base, and then I'll call this quad drive yards base as well. So this is the base, and this is the dock width. And now dock width, you'll see how that correlates when I do planets, and see how that works together. And I'll make sure that it has like a little man that tells you where to dock, which is always good. And that's it. It's pretty actually easy to do for this. Now it gets a little more complicated with planets because of it requires a different object, which is the docking buoy. I'm just going to change this to the planet Kuat docking buoy. Positioning is a little bit more difficult here. I'll use the same IDS name because you have to keep in mind that you need this docking buoy to dock at the planet. So you have to think about where everything is. So the atmospheric range has a radius of 28,000 meters. So I have to think about where do I want this planet in relation to the size of it. So I like to keep the docking buoy outside the atmosphere in most cases, or just a little bit in. It really doesn't matter too much as long as it's further away from the death zone itself, which is 26,000. So in this case, I want to place it more north in the system. So I'll just make this really easy for me, and I'll make this a 00. And that will mean that this will be 28,000 meters more north than the planet, if that makes sense. Now, rotation comes into play when you actually go into game, because what will happen is when you undock, depending on the rotation, that's the way you'll come out. So sometimes it's actually inadvertently put towards the planet. So when you undock from the planet, you'll go actually towards it and die. So you can usually change that with the Z value, and depending if it's 180 degrees or 90 degrees, you can just change it from there. And the archetype is the landing buoy itself, and I want to dock with the planet Kuat base. So you see that to make a planet dockable, you need to say that this is actually a base and give it a reputation as well. Like that, and I'll say it's a KDY rep, and let's say this is Kuat. Planet Kuat base, like that. And that should make it actually dockable. So planets are a little bit different because of the, say, dock width, and then that the game knows to dock it with this planet. And you usually want to keep them the same reputation. I think that's about it. That's good for this part right here. Just making sure I got it all. Okay. And then this one here. So what I do now is then you have to make sure that the game registers it, and the only way you do that is going into the universe file, the big one, so data universe, and adding it here. So you see all the bases must be added to the universe ID, or you won't be able to dock there. So I'll add a new entry. Call this cool. squat. So, and I'll just grab this here. Okay, so I'll call it this one, planet quad base, until it's in the system quad. And you can use the same IDS here, so I'll use this one here. Voila. And then I'm going to change this. And this is where it finds all the base information to quad. And then I'm going to change this to planet quad base. And there you go. And you can keep this base run by the same. It does. You can use that over and over again. And that's what I've been doing the entire time. Now I'll just make this easy on myself here. This is quad drive yards base and quad using this number. Change this to that. To this right here. There you go. So I made these two now readable by the actual system itself, the universe file here. So I'm just going to save that. And now that the game will actually pick this up. So it's important that I put the information properly in there. Okay. So now because of that, I have to go back to my universe file in my TAL. And add my links to it. I think Key already did that with the bases and rooms. Good. So the first one is called, so you have to make sure the names are always the same. So the first one is called Kuat Dragard's Base. You call that an INE. And then the next one is called Planet Quad Base, and you call that an ID too. I like to keep this nomenclature rather than this naming up, just because it makes it a lot easier than me call something like a NR01 or 04, and it's kind of a little more difficult to figure it out. It takes longer to type in, but it's a lot easier when if people want to go back to the mod later and change it, they know where they're actually changing it. So it's just a lot easier for everybody that way. So anyways, now that I'm done that, I will do my cheating here. I go back to 1.68 and use the old base files that Elderbad made, because it's just a lot easier to do that as the system stuff, rather than all the base stuff worked really well. It's been pretty much all tested out, so to use it, it's just a lot easier. Within all this bug finding and whatnot. Now, the only problem is that it has all that old nomenclature that I didn't like. Sometimes you kind of have to root through it all and figure it all out. Now, when I was editing some of 1.68, I usually put the all the planet info there. However, in this case, I don't think I did. Oh, this is Kuat. I think this is the actual Kuat planet. So then what I'd usually do is just I'll copy all this, and then I'll go back to here and change that to this. So then I have some editing to do now. So I'll call this Planet Kuat Base. It'll start in the planetscape. So when you see that those THN sequences that Elderbear made, this is it. This is the link to it. To make the route to the bar, I need to make a TAL file here, systems quad, which is alright, bases room, and I usually call this planet quad bar. Okay, and then same thing, change this to TAL, and then bases, rooms, and then planet quad cityscape. And I've already plugged in all that solar information to do these landscapes, rather the planetscapes, so it's actually pretty easy. All you got to do is change the values here. And so I'll save that. And then I'll just do the quad drive yards really quick here. hopefully you'll have quad drive yards. There it is. Okay, so it's quad 09. So going back to bases. Quad 09 right there. So I'm just gonna copy that. Paste it in here. And this is called quad drive yards base. And this will start on the deck. And then I'll change this to tau quad bases room. And call this quad drive yards bar. Okay, and this will do the deck information, and I'll change that to tau again, bases, rooms, quad drive yards, deck. It's deck. Okay, so that's done. So just making sure I did all that right. Let's go back here for a second. Okay. Oops. So it's gonna change the view here for me. There you go. So it's quad drive yards base, which is right. I'm just going to go in there and make sure I did it all right here. Quad drive yards bar, quad drive yards deck, right? And maybe I did a mistake there. So just because it asked me to save, I'm going to be careful. And maybe I made a spelling mistake, unfortunately. And then I'll save it. Quad drive base, planet quad base, and that's here. Just making sure, quad base, planet quad bar, planet quad skill escape, but that's alright. Okay. So I'm going to save that, that's good. Now rooms, and this is where it specifies, for example, the docking room and the seat escape and all that fun stuff. So, because I know that this right here is all the information for the Quat planet, so I'll change this to... Now, the reason why this didn't come up in the rooms file is that it will actually come up in mBases. I'll show you what I mean there. Actually, that's not my planet quad. This is my giant. Is this? Cityscape. Now, on cityscapes, usually there's different rooms that will sometimes come up in the rooms in the bases file. However, sometimes they come up in the mBases INE, depending on where the people are. So I'll show you when I get into the mBases what that means in more detail. Changing this one to what ship dealer. Alright, that's done. I have to edit all the things now. All the scripts are in tau, so I have to change that. The scene is actually in tau as well, so change that as well. Now the music, I usually change the music of the bar to either there's Cantina 1, 2, 3, or 4. I'll make this Cantina 1, and everything else is good. I don't have to change anything else, which is nice. I show you where those scripts are, right here. And you'll see they're either in the bases here, So in this case, it'd be the KOTOR bar corporate, which is right there. And this is another type scene. So this is the ambient, and this is the script. So when it moves in, that's the THN files, which I know very little about. That's of Aldebaran's department, most definitely. Anyways, getting back to what I'm doing here. Lots of files here. Alright. There you go. So then that's all done. That's what I wanted. I'll save that. Oh, and always make sure to take out the mission vendor here, because we're not doing any missions for 2.0. So, see that there? The IDS hotspot mission vendor, take that out. Because we don't want any missions. Save that. And Cityscape, once again, change that to Tau. And this one goes to Tau as well. And this script's basis, that is just normal freelancer stuff. So you can leave that without changing to Tau. And the sound, once again, I'll just leave that there. And I have to change the landing script here. So that's uses the Coruscant one. And everything should be good there. Now you'll see that all the different rooms correspond to this file here, so the hotspots. So they all have to be named in here, and you can see it actually becomes quite the huge file. So that's why I just tend to copy 1.68 and use their information, since it's all been tried and true, and we use it in all our mods, and it's nice to reuse the stuff from other people's work to make the mod better. So there you go, that's all done there. And then equipment here, this uses the equipment from the stock mod. Stock freelancer, so I don't really need to edit this. I'll just make sure though, because you always can check if you need to add a Tau to it by going to the scripts files. So it's going to say some bases and it's BR. So looking at it, I don't need that. And just to make sure that I know it's in the stock freelancer here, I'm going to go there. So it's in data, scripts, bases, you'll see it's right there, BR3. So there you go. Okay. So now that's done. I'll just close that. City, it's done. The bar, that's done. I did the equipment, don't need to do anything there. The ship dealer, once again, it's using old stock freelancer stuff. So if you remember the rooms that we saw in Freelancer, this is where that's linking to. Now you can do something a little bit different. I don't think actually Coruscant did it any differently, but let me just check here. So you can see it's a lot easier to navigate what you're trying to do by making it all like this. Equipment. Yeah, it just uses old stock freelancer stuff. Alright, anyways, I'm back to Kawat here. Okay, that's the ship dealer. I think the trader was the last one. And I can leave that all the same as well. So that's all done now. And I just have to add for the drive yards one. So going back towards that, which is in the 1.68. Which room it was in. Let's see. So it's number 9. Nice. Huh. Strange enough that that doesn't have one. So I'm just going to use old Coruscant stuff here, just making sure that it has a very similar structure. So what I am going to do here is steal Coruscant's these shipyards here, just making sure that they have the similar things. So it's a deck and bar. Actually, I may not want to use the shipyards, thinking about it. Let's see. Because the reason why I don't want to use it is that, I'll show you. The Quat shipyards, sorry, Coruscant shipyards, the deck is a NR deck, which I don't think will be good for a neutral type planet there. So, I think I might use the Tolgordal, which is a civilian deck, which I like better, I think. Alright, so that's what I'll use here. Because it has all the same thing. That's a deck, a ship dealer, and a bar, which is all important, because you need a bar in all your seat. Alright, thanks. You need the alcohol, apparently. Okay. So I'll change that to Quad Drive Yards. So that's the bar. So unfortunately, this is all done. You can see that the Tau files are there, sort of Tau script for the Kotar, Tau script for the Kotar again. And then I have this type of music in there for this cantina deck. It's a civilian hardpoint deck, so this is Tau, this is Tau. Oh, also for the bar, always make sure that the missions are gone, mission vendor, and that is gone. And last one here. In this case, the deck is a standard a freelancer one, so I didn't have to change that there. Okay, so that's all done, which is nice. Now the only thing left we have to do is do the M bases, INE, and I'll go to that now. Okay. So M bases INE are found in missions. This is all, it is in its glory. It is quite an extensive file for little people, to say the least. So, I'm just going to steal this up here. Make the Quat file. Okay, so I'm just going to change this to Quat. Excuse me. Alright, and put that in here. Now, since I got the information from the 1.68 folder, fortunately I can use most of that and just input it in here. So I'll go to that and base is there. Missions. This is what I'm doing anyway, so I'm just going to copy all this, and I'll show you how I change it. This is what I'm adding it to. Okay. So I had to change this nickname to, obviously, the Planet Co-op base. I gotta change the local rep to KDY, because we don't have that difficulty, and that's set to 1. Doesn't really matter, because we're not doing any missions. This I can take out, because I don't need it. So you can see that I don't use that up here. So I'll take that out. Mission vendors, I'm going to change to 00. I'm just going to open up another end bases here, just to use that for reference, because it's been a little while. So this means that it offers between 8 and 12 missions if we were going to have missions, but we don't. Now, for base faction, for any type of NPC you want, if you want different NPCs with different reputations, you need to add a base faction one. And weight has to always equal 100, or none of the NPCs will show up in the bar. And you can make them do different things, depending on what you want them to do, rather like rumors, or they can tell you, give you reputations, or they can give you missions. In this case, we're not going to do any missions, so that takes all that out. For bribes and things, I might put that in later, but not for now. And I'm only going to have one type of reputation here, just for the sake of, because you can always add that later. So I'm going to change that group to KDY. That's the NPC it links to. Change the offers missions to false, because I don't want it to offer any missions. And I'm just going to add these fellas here. Okay. And I can delete all this, because I don't need that anymore. Okay. And so I'm just going to call this, so anything Quad01. Actually do this really quick. Quad01, I'm going to change to Planet Quad. So, let's see here. And you have to make sure, I'll get into that in a sec, actually. Okay, so that's changed. So, you have to make sure that these NPC names right here match exactly with these NPC names right here, or your game will crash right away. You go into the base, which really sucks, and it's very aggravating, trust me. So, in this case, I don't want him to do anything, and this is where you'll specify if you want him to do any type of bribes and whatnot. So, for example, if you go to the very beginning, you'll see that these fellas here will give either rumors, or they'll give you reputation. So, this example, this guy will give a rumor, and this guy will give a bribe to join the Imperial Navy. So I'll just let you know what that is. So later on, when we have like our Nexus and whatnot, we'll put the bribes in for all the different fellas. But just right now, I just want working things. Okay, so. Just trying to start here. Okay, that works too. So I'm going to change this. We're going to leave it NR. I don't really have a preference of what the NPCs are, as long as the names match. So I just make sure real quick, and they do. This is the body type. I usually, because I'm funny sometimes, I like to put the orientations right, so I'll put the head on top of the body. Now heads have to be right, or they crash the game, which sucks. And it's very, very, very aggravating. So we always have to make sure that your heads match the code in the body parts INE. Fortunately, it will. I've worked through all those bugs, so everything that you should put down should match. Now, sometimes I keep the names, sometimes I don't, and I'll go to this Star Wars name generator, which should be Star Wars random name generator, which I use here, and I'll just use the names that it comes up with. So, for example, if I have some males that I need names for, I generate it, and voila, I get all my names. I usually put all the names first, and then I start adding the individual names, and this is, you have to use the freelancer IDS generator. Or here, I'll show you this one here that I used for all my IDS things. So this right here. So make sure that the rep is fine. So rebel group, and I don't want to destroy any permissions, so I'll take that out. It has a right and left hand. And I'm gonna change this. I'll change it after I go through it. So this matches with that, which is good. I have a pirate body, a pirate head. And I need to change that later. And this was gonna have, say, the empire. Actually, it's gonna have KUI rep because of this. The rep has to match the fellas too. Because I don't want them to do any rumors, and I don't want any missions right now. Okay, and this one matches that. I'm just going to call this 1, just because, actually, what I'm going to do here. Ooh. I saw that. Some crashes. Let's call this 2. Change those respectively to these. Okay, so those names are in. Making sure this rep is right, KDY. And I don't like the fact that they all have the same voices, which is kind of freaky. So Dev was nice enough when he did all of this. Let's pull this up. He put all the voices here, so I'm gonna change some of the voices real quick. So this will be 106. This is a male. Male. And I'm gonna change this one. He's gonna have a 26 voice. There you go. And then I'm going to delete this. Now the fixed dealers are the ones that will sell the things. So this, for example, will be the bartender. This will be the ship dealer. This will be the trader. And this will be the weapons dealer. So I'm just going to change this to Jones. Usually I just use the name generator, but I'm kind of lazy right now, so I don't feel like it. So, oh, and these nicknames have to match these things down here. And character density, what that has to do with how many people you can have at a bar at a given point, and the planetscape is how many people you can have in that planetscape at a given point. So, I'm just going to change the voices here, so it's going to be 46, 51. Alright. That way they'll have different voices and they have different characters to them. I think I just gotta change the reputations here. Done. I'm just going to do the IDS stuff really quickly, figuring out where I started with. I think that was the last number that I used. So this is kind of a boring part, but a necessary one if you want the names to come up properly. So you can see the names go in there. Some type of name patch here. Okay. Okay, so it looks like I finished there. So you see, it's always good to check the numbers and make sure that you're not stepping on anybody's toes. Clear spot here. Starting at see if that's clear as well. Okay, so looks like that's clear from then on in. So I'll start with this number. And then put that to the bar regulars. So those are the guys that pop into the bar. And I'm gonna put that name here. Let's call them actually. Let's copy that. Voila, it's done. And the 31. Put this name here, so I'm going to copy that. Save it, and put that number in there. So once again, kind of a boring part, but a necessary one. You want the names to come up. So I'm just putting the names in here, nothing special, if you're still watching. And then 36 here. Nothing there. Okay, there you go, that should be the Planet Quad all done now. Making sure that these all match up, which they do. It should hopefully work when I go into the system. Now I'm just going to do the last one. That's the the quad drive yards. Now since I used the Tolbert-L information, I like to keep wherever I got the information. The M base is the same, so I'll use that M base there just for consistency's sake. So I'll just have to really just change the names here. Shouldn't be too bad. And then last one up here. Alright, so change this to quad drive yards. To the KDY group again. And then KDY here. And you can see how I wanted different groups. And this is what they're in. And this right here is a civilian group, so you know. So we're going to make all these guys group here. Just going to delete that. Just going to call them KD Wires. I'm going to replace that with KD Wire. The reason why I didn't click replace all is because there's a Tolgardel up there, and I would replace all that. I wouldn't want that. So, I'm just going to call these guys. Let's get 2, 3, this would be 4. Now, it doesn't really matter how many you place in, whether they be, 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 or even 1. I'm just placing it just for the sake of placing them in. So once again, make sure all the nicknames are correct. This one's 2. This one can be 3. And this one can be 4. Alright, that's done there. So, you want to change the body here a bit. Let's see here. I'll give them the same body. Actually. And all the reputations can be found in the data initial worlds, and that's where all your reputations can be found there. So I'm just changing those reps so they match. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that's all good. I'll have to do the names, which I'll show you how I do. Once again, change these, the KDY. So, alright. So I'm going to go to my random name generator now. Keep this here. And start plugging out some names. There it is. And I want males, and I say I want about 25. Okay, so we'll start here. So Kit, Jax. I don't need you anymore. So start here. Okay. Got it. So it's not too difficult here, just getting all the names right. Once again, it's a little bit tedious. But you can find shortcuts. If you listen to some music, it's not so bad, but it's a very important part of the game, so that's why we gotta do it. I'll just have to add the names to these, the numbers. So our last one was that. Okay, so we're almost done here, fortunately. And then you can go test it out in game. Okay. Okay, that works. again. Nothing special. Right there. Right. Okay, so all the numbers are right. So it should be good. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to... this right here is all the script kind of stuff of how the fellows move. Okay, so I think this is done. I'm going to save this, and now I'm going to try to test it out. So, first thing I always do, so I'm just going to copy over this, copy over my freelancer folder. So, and then I'm going to load the mod, and if I did something wrong, it usually pops up right away. And if not, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop this. And then go in game and record that and show you guys what the new bases look like while I'm there. So you can see it takes some time to add just only two bases. It took me about almost an hour. That's actually knowing what you're doing. That doesn't include any bug fixing as well. Sometimes that takes even longer in the actual process of coding it in. You have to go through all the files that you've changed and look for any type of errors. So the good thing about using old 1.68 data is that most of it is already checked. All you have to do is make sure of the things that you've changed to make it work in 2.0. So it's a process in itself, but once you get used to it, actually it comes quite quickly. And I think the first base that I did actually took me about 2 hours to do. And you can see why system building takes so long. There's just so many different aspects of it, and this is not even yet. Although I'm done this, I still have to put all the market ships in and market equipment into that particular base. But anyways, that's kind of easy, and I'll show you how to do that really quickly. So I'm going to load up Freelancer now, and hopefully it loads. I'm going to check if there's any errors. So there's all the stuff that we know of here. So it looks like it's loaded. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to stop this video, and I'm going to go in game, and I'll meet you there. Okay, it was a pleasure, guys.